In this video, we'll learn how to use pixel images in p5js. So far in this unit, we've mostly been working with function calls that actually create vector images, the kinds that we'd mostly be making in Adobe Illustrator. But we also have the option to bring in pixel-based images to our sketches. To practice, I've got the demo files folder open for this week, and here I've got three sample images. One of peanut butter, jelly, and a baseball bat. These represent the three easiest pixel image file types to use in p5js. So we've got GIF, which are good since they're generally the smallest in file size. So if you're dealing with lots of images or copies of an image in a sketch, using a GIF could help avoid slowing down the browser. The downside is that GIF has the lowest fidelity, so it can't capture as many fine gradations of color. It does support transparency, but it's only one-bit transparency. So the pixels are either fully opaque or fully transparent, which can sometimes appear jagged. PNGs give us the highest fidelity, so really good for photographic imagery with lots of colors, but they have the biggest file size. If you're using lots of images, you might want to choose a different format than PNG. They do support 8-bit transparency, which means that parts of our image, like this drop shadow that are semi-transparent, will be represented more accurately. JPEG has good fidelity, so we can show lots of photographic detail while still keeping the file size lower than PNG. The downside is that JPEGs don't support any transparency, so if we're bringing this image into our sketch, the white background will be included. Before we start using images, we need to upload them to the internet so we can access them in our code. One way to do that is right through the P5 editor. Just below the play button and above the line number column, we have a button with a little arrow. I'll go ahead and click on that. And this shows me a column called sketch files. Here I see sketch.js, which holds all my code, plus the other supporting files that help my sketch work in the browser. I'll click the drop down next to sketch files and create a folder to store my images. Then click the drop down next to my new folder and click on upload file. Now I'll select my images and just drag them and drop them into the browser. Okay, looks like those have finished uploading. Now I can collapse that sketch files column back to the left. To actually get an image into our code, we need to follow three main steps. First, I'll declare a variable to hold the pixel data for one image. Then in setup, I'll initialize that variable by using the loadImage function. That takes as an argument the file path of the image in quotation marks, and this is what transfers the pixel data from the file into my variable. Now make sure to include the folder name followed by a slash, and double check that everything is spelled exactly right. The final step is to use the image function in the draw loop to display the image on our canvas. Image takes three arguments. The first is the variable that's holding our image data, and the second two are the pixel coordinates for the top left corner of our image. If we'd like to show the image at a different scale, we can optionally specify a third and fourth argument, which are the width and height in pixels that we'd like to display the image. For example, I made these images each at 150 pixels square, but I could use those third and fourth arguments to make them larger or smaller. So I'll go ahead and set up one more image variable. And when I get to putting the image function in the draw block, I'll use mouse X and mouse Y for the location, and this gives me an interactive image. So this helps us see that the output of the image function is pretty much just like any other shape function call that we've used so far. It follows the same layering rules, and it can be combined with variables to make it behave in the exact same ways. Okay, that's how to use pixel images in p5js.